Okay, so if you are able to see the screen, so let us start today, next part of our lecture. So as we discussed last time, if you recall, then we discussed two configurations. One is a common source with diode connected circuit, which had a diode here. So this is one of the configurations of the common source, and the other one was common source with current source load, which is this one. So these two were connected at the drain terminal of the MOSFET M1. So these are the two variants of that. So now we will discuss the third variant, which we also called as emitter degeneration. The name will, become evident as we go down the line, but it's called as emitter degeneration circuit. So let us discuss what is that. So if you have a MOSFET M1 here, and then you have load resistor RD, input signal is there here Vin, and then we have source resistor RS here. So if this is the configuration, and note that earlier in our earlier case, in the two configurations that we discussed earlier, our RS was 0. So if it is 0, that means it is connected to ground, and this RD was implemented using current source load and the diode connected load. So if you recall, this RD was implemented either using this transistor or using this transistor, a diode connected load. So my point here is to discuss with you is, like, people come up with different variations of the architecture. Like, for example, here they are now right now keeping it as RD, but sometimes they will keep, this transistor over here, which is a diode connected, which is a current source load, and sometimes they will connect a diode connected load. So the point here to be noted is, different configurations will boil down to a simple configuration circuit which looks like this. This is a simple common source circuit having the source resistance here in the source terminal and the drain resistance applied at the drain terminal. The only difference that comes in various configurations that you will see in the book will be either they will replace RD by some MOSFET configurations which are given like this and this. So the important point here is to analyze the circuit and think of that circuit, in terms of the, and bring that circuit into a very simple form. That is the main objective that you should keep in your mind. Whenever you see any complex circuit, try to make it reduce into a form which you already know. So if you know this circuit, the one which we are discussing here right now, so try to bring it in this form so that whatever variants you will have, the answer will remain same for all the cases. So let me show you that. What do I mean by that? So what I am saying is, if you have this configuration, you know that this is the quite common configuration having source resistance here and the drain resistance this side, and then we have VDD here and a Vin. This is quite common as far as common source is concerned. The only difference that can happen here is in terms of either RS will be 0 or maybe RD is 0. So depending upon which resistance is 0, you will have multiple such configurations of M1 common source transistor, and it can be the case that when both RS and RD are not equal to 0, it can be the situation of that also, and this is one such configuration. And RS and RD can be implemented using MOSFETs also. So we have to, look into the circuit. And instead of drawing the small signal equivalent every time and make our life difficult, we should, try to reduce the circuit, try to reduce the complex circuit in such a way that after the reduction, the circuit should come into a form which is very simple, which is given over here. And you know the gain, if you know the gain of this transistor, this configuration, then you can just substitute the RS and RD that you will calculate for any complex circuitry which is attached here on these RS and RD. Instead of RD and RS, you will have some complex circuitry then you have to calculate the RD and RS for that, and then you substitute and get the voltage gain. So if you have any doubts here, let me know, otherwise we will proceed further. So this is our main motivation of doing this thing. So the thing is, now we will understand what is the voltage gain, output resistance and input resistance for this particular configuration. So as it is clearly visible that input resistance will be infinite here, it is infinite here, because you are looking into the gate terminal, and gate terminal offers infinite resistance to the input source Vin, which is connected directly to the gate. So now we want to calculate the voltage gain of this transistor. We want to see what voltage gain this particular configuration is offering to us. So in order to do that, what we do is we connect Vin like this. It's very simple. Then we will draw the small signal equivalent of the MOSFET M1, which will be like this. It is GM. Let us say this MOSFET is M1, so it will be GM1 VGS. Okay, and let us say we are ignoring lambda, we are ignoring output resistance. RO is 0, and this is indicated by putting a value of lambda equal to 0. That means your output resistance of the MOSFET is 0. So if the output resistance of the MOSFET is 0, we will not connect anything here. And then what is the source resistance? Source resistance is connected to the drain of this MOSFET. So this is RS, and this is your drain terminal, this is your gate terminal, this is your source terminal. And what about the drain resistance? Drain resistance is connected here. This is your RD, and this is what I am calling it right now as node A. If I call this as node A, and this will be A, and this is same as this A here. And node VDD is grounded here because we are actually currently considering small signal circuits, in which small signal analysis, in which the voltage sources are short circuited. And this is your V out. So if I want to calculate voltage gain of V out by V in, what will that be? If I want to calculate the voltage gain of this particular configuration, what will that be? So let us copy this and check what is the voltage gain for this particular configuration. Okay, so let us apply, let me remove this just to avoid confusion. So this is your, just a second, just to avoid confusion, let us remove this also and this also. So this is gone, and this is actually VGS. So the voltage that is connected between between this gate terminal and the source terminal is VGS, and this value of VGS is what? This value of VGS is VG minus VS, and that is equivalent to V in minus VA. I think everybody agrees with this, because this is the potential at source terminal and its value is A. So now if you apply KCL in whatever sense, you know, it depends on your choice, like the way you work it out, but it will be, I will write it over here. So the thing is, you know, this is the current source that is actually flowing through this resistance RS, and it is flowing like this, right? So if it is flowing like this, what is the potential difference it generates? The potential difference that it generates is like in this format. That is, from high potential to low potential, current flows. So it will be like this. Then what is the voltage V out? The voltage V out is written as GM1 VGS, which is the current that it is flowing through the RS, times RS. And what will be the polarity here? Is it plus or minus? Anyone? Is it right the way I have written? Anyone of you can answer this? Is it right or wrong?
Minus will come, sir.
Okay, how about other students? BTech students, are you do you agree with
yes sir, there will be negative sign.
Okay, so the thing is this will be negative because with respect to ground the value is minus, because we are seeing with respect to the ground its value is minus, so that's why it minus will come here. So this is the first equation, and now you know what, now you have to apply here also at node A. You apply KCL here. So if you apply KCL at this node A, what will that be? It will be VA over RD equal to GM1 VGS. So whatever current it is flowing out from this node is equal to the current that is flowing into the node. So I am applying that rule over here. Current flowing out is equal to the current flowing in. So this value is what? This value is, again we know VGS. VGS is Vin minus VA, and this is VA over RD. So you can take the VA out from here. So the value of VA is how much? It will be GM1 Vin over GM1 plus 1 over RD. So this will be your okay, one thing I forgot to tell you here, I actually swapped the resistances. It is not RD here, it is, you know, it is RS this side and RD this side. So if that is the case, then this will be RD and this will be RS, like this. So this is what it is, just to, you know, avoid that confusion. So it's connected to the source, that's why it's RS. So this is the voltage VA, which the value of which is GM1 Vin upon GM1 plus 1 over RS, which can also be simplified as GM1 RS over 1 plus GM1 RS times Vin. So this is the unknown potential that is over here. So you want to, you know, substitute it back to here, because you want to calculate the value of V out by V in, and VA is coming as a trouble for you. So you have to eliminate that variable. So what is value of V out from here? The value of V out is minus GM1. Then you have VGS, which is V in minus VA times RD, and then you substitute this value over here. So it will be GM1 V in minus GM1 RS V in over 1 plus GM1 RS times RD equal to V out. So what is the value of V out by V in now? Because you can see now everything is in V out and V in, and VA is cancelled. So the value of V out by V in, if you solve this, it's very easy to solve. So the value will be minus GM1 RD over 1 plus GM1 RS. So this is the answer in case of the configuration where you have resistance at the source as well as in the drain. So if any complex circuitry is there, if you can bring it down back to this, if you can bring it down back to this format, then you can directly put the values of RD and RS, because you already know that the voltage gain for these type of circuits where RD and RS is there is this. So you can directly put the values. We will see an example to further, you know, solidify the concept that we have discussed, but this is the thing. So now the important point is, you can think of it as in a different sense. And what is that? It is like this. You can, you know, write it as minus RD over 1 over GM 1 plus RS. You can write like that also. If you solve it, its value will be same as the one which is given over here. So what it shows? It shows you one important thing, and the thing is, you know, you have a MOSFET M1 here, okay? Then you have a drain resistance RD connected to it, and you have a source resistance RS which is connected here, okay? This you already know. This is the configuration you already know. So if you want to calculate the voltage gain directly without going into this trouble, like, you know, without going into calculating all this again and again, because, you know, in complex circuits, you don't want to, you know, do all this KCL and KVL and write nodal analysis or KCL, KVL again and again. So there are some shortcuts that you can, you know, think of while writing the voltage gains. What is this shortcut? The shortcut is, here it is written that voltage gain is RD over 1 over GM plus RS. What it means is, you know, it is basically in the bottom of this is basically 1 over GM1 plus RS. That means you have something like this, you know, you have a resistance RS here. And I have told you that if you look into the source of this MOSFET M1, if you look into the source of this MOSFET M1, it is giving you a feeling that it is giving you a resistance of value 1 over GM1. This is actually the main important concept here. Like, if you see from the source, the value that it is offering to you is 1 over GM. So it is something like this. So the total resistance that it is getting, you know, when you look from total resistance from this side to this side, you know, from this point to this point, it is giving you a total resistance of 1 over GM1 plus RS. That is the total resistance you can see, because it is acting in the series with 1 over RS. And how about the top? The top thing is the total resistance which is connected from the drain terminal of the MOSFET. So basically now you can easily write the voltage gain of these kind of transistors by connecting by writing the total resistance offered at the drain, total resistance offered at drain divided by the total resistance offered at source. So you calculate the total resistance from the drain terminal, you calculate the total resistance from the source terminal, and divide both of them upon each other, and you will get the answer. That end with a minus sign. So that is the voltage gain that you have for this particular configuration which we have discussed. So if you have any questions here, you can ask. Okay, so this is the voltage gain. Now we have output resistance to be calculated for this particular configuration, R capital O, right? Rather than small RO, it's capital RO. So what is output resistance? I told you already in our last lecture. If the output resistance is, you apply a test voltage and test current into the on the output terminal, and you short the input voltage. That is, if you have any complex circuit represented by this, then what you do, you apply test voltage here with the test current, and you ground the input terminals to calculate the output resistance for this particular network. So if that is the case, then how to do it with this particular thing, this particular architecture? It's very easy. Let's copy this again. So this is there. So with this particular setup of calculating the output resistance, what should we do here? We should we should do what? We should remove this here, and then what? You will apply a voltage source here, which is the test voltage VT, and then a test current IT. This is same as this, and then your input is grounded, so this will be grounded. And this is already, this is already grounded here. Okay, so when this is the case, what will be now? Your this is grounded, this is not. So what is VGS? Your VGS now is VG minus VS, and VG is 0. What is VS? VS is VA. So your VGS now is equal to minus VA. This is the thing. And now if you want to calculate the output resistance, what you have to do is you have to calculate basically VT over IT. So in order to calculate that, it's very easy here. You just apply nodal analysis at this point. At this point, again, I have written it wrong. It has to be, RD here and RS this side. So if I write nodal analysis or, here, then what will be the value of that? What will be the equation? Equation will be VT divided by RD equivalent to current flowing minus GM1 VGS. So you can cross verify also yourself that what will this value be, because here what will happen is VT over RD is the current that is flowing this in this node like this. And how about the other one, the GM VGS? It is also flowing like this, and this current IT is flowing like this. It is going into the node. So this is the, you can say, KCL at node D. Is it okay, the equation that I have written, or is there any problem in understanding it? Let me know. Anyone have any problems in understanding this?
No, sir.
Okay, so this is the equation that you write at node D, and now you can solve it. What will be the answer here? If you solve it, then it will be VT over RD equal to IT minus GM1. What is the value of VGS? VGS is VZ minus VS, which is VA. So its answer is IT plus GM1 VA, and this is VT over RD. This is the first equation. And now the thing is, you have to calculate VT over IT actually to calculate RT. So in that situation, you have to write here also at this node VA. So you have to calculate the value of VA here. So what is the value of VA? The value of VA is GM1 VGS times RS, because GM1 VGS is the current which is flowing in this node, and it's plus minus here, so its value will be this, and this is equal to GM1 RS. What is VGS? VGS is 0 minus VA. So if you solve this, your answer will be 0. The voltage VA, the potential at node VA is 0. If the potential at node VA is 0, this is 0. This is 0. So your VT over IT is RD. So this is the output resistance that you get when you apply your test voltage and the current source IT at the output terminal like this. And the reason why we are getting RD over here is because we are not assuming any output resistance of this MOSFET. So please note that our output resistance is not there. This output resistance, which we were assuming earlier, is not there. So now it's an exercise for you people that if output resistance comes like the way it is over here, if the output resistance comes here, then the output resistance will actually affect the your test voltage, affect the resistance, and even the, yeah, this one. this will be affected. How will it be affected? Then you have to solve yourself. So can you do this? Like if I apply output resistance at the output terminal here, what will its effect be on the output resistance of the complete architecture? Anyone? Can you solve this? If output resistance is there? Okay, so I'll give you a few minutes to do it, but before that I just want to, you know, solve one question so that you will feel comfortable of what I'm saying. And the second thing is, then we will, you know, I'll give you 5 minutes to ask you to solve this particular configuration. So let me first of all draw this circuit. Let us say we have this MOSFET M1, and then we have this, you know, M2 here, like this, connected, and then we have RD this side, VDD, and then we have V in this side. Okay, so this is the configuration that you have right now. So I want to ask you that without calculating anything, without calculating by replacing it with small signal equivalents and doing this, can you calculate the voltage gain of this circuit without calculating anything? Can you give me the answer, like what will be the answer for this particular circuit? I give you 2 minutes to solve this, and I want all of you to discuss on this. So within 2 to 3 minutes, I think you should be able to solve it, and I will ask each of you again one by one. So right now it's 12:27. I will ask you somewhere around 12:30. Recording now. Okay, so you see here, my as I discussed just the previous in one or two slides back, our main interest is to reduce it to a configuration which we know already. So what is that configuration which we know already? The configuration that we know already is something like this, you know, something like this. You know that you know this thing is, you already know, and you have calculated the gain of this as minus RD over 1 over GM1, which is the MOSFET M1 plus RS. So this you already have calculated for this particular configuration, and this is your Vout here. So my point was, in our earlier discussion also, how to you know reduce this to this format, how to reduce it to this particular circuit. That is our main, you know, intention of you know using main intention of doing it, so that we can escape the recalculation of doing the same thing again and again. So in order to do that, if you see, this is your MOSFET M1, which is a common source amplifier, which is acting as a common source amplifier, and you know at the source you have, you know, this M2 which is connected, and this M2 which is connected here is some way or the other is acting as a resistor of equal value, of a value equal to RS. So let us say if you are able to calculate the resistance that is offered by this MOSFET M2, then what you can do, you can keep that value in place of RS here. Whereas the RD is same as this RD, so there is no point in, you know, changing this RD. The only thing that you need to change is RS. So if you can calculate this value of this particular architecture, then you can easily replace by the value of RS, and then the answer is minus RD over 1 over GM1 plus the one which you will calculate now. So the MOSFET M1 is here, this is your Vin, this is your RD, and this is your VDD. So what you do is, this is your MOSFET M2, and its gate and drain are connected to ground. So you are actually looking from here. You are actually looking from top to bottom. So you have to calculate the value of resistance, the output resistance offered by this MOSFET M2. And if you see closely that this particular thing here, I have calculated it earlier also, that's why I'm not calculating. And the thing is, this is ground and this is also ground. That means it is equivalent to joining the two and connected to ground. Is it right or not? So both of them are ground, means you can connect the two together and connect to ground. And what is this? This you have already discussed, it's a diode connected transistor. So it's a diode connected transistor which we have already discussed earlier. And what is the value of this transistor when output resistance, when you look from the source, the value is 1 over GM2. Very easy, right? There is no point in drawing the small signal equivalent again. And the point and the reason for that is you have already done this exercise once. So the main thing is how to reduce the complex architecture so that you reach to the architecture where you already know the analysis of that. So what you have done, you have disconnected it first, make it like this, then you further simplified it like this, and then you realize it's a diode connected transistor and the value is this. So now you have calculated this value of RS. So let's put it here. So its value will be 1 over GM to this side. So this is the answer for the voltage gain without calculating the small signal equivalents by writing, there is another way out also. You replace all the MOSFETs M1 and M2 by their small signal equivalents and then draw it and then calculate the V out by V in. It is very, tedious and complex. Instead of that, break the circuit and make it simple. So are you able to follow what I am telling here? Any questions in regard to what I have discussed, or if there are no questions, then we can move forward. Okay, so the important thing that I wanted to discuss, and I've also given you as a sort of experimental work, is this one. Like, if you connect your resistance RO here, then what will happen? And if, for example, your RD is zero, for example, let us assume that your RD is zero. You can keep RD also, it will make things, more complex. You can do that exercise also. But for me, if RD is zero, let us say, or infinite, you can say, so it's open circuited, so there is no RD here. There is no RD here. And you keep only RO. You keep only RO, the output resistance, and then you calculate the output resistance R out. So the value of that will be, in earlier case when RD was there, the output resistance was RD, but when you keep RO only and you remove RD for time being, then what happens is the output resistance value will be this. This will be the output resistance for this particular circuit, this one, when only RO is there and there is no RD. So why it is called as emitter degeneration resistor circuit, the one which we have written here? It is called as emitter degeneration because the emitter is coming from BJT actually, but it's not BJT here, or sometimes it's also a source degeneration, not emitter degeneration. So the reason why we are calling it as source degeneration is that because of this resistance at the source terminal, this resistor at the source terminal, what happens is because of this, source resistor terminal connection, the gain increases. It's like GMRS. So the output resistance increases because of this source resistance. So your output resistance, which was earlier RO, is now increased to 1 plus GMRS. So there is a factor which increases the output resistance tremendously. So earlier, if RO is, let us say, 10K, then because 1 plus GMRS is multiplied with this RO, it boosted it to, let us say, 100K. So your output resistance is increased. And you can, further simplify it as RO GMRS. because this GMRS is much much greater than 1. That's why you can write it like this also. So now you can see why this circuit is called as source degeneration. It is called as source degeneration because the source resistor is enhancing the output resistance by a factor of GMRS. That is why it is called as source degeneration. So this exercise you have to do yourself and understand how it is going on. And in your exam also, something or the other in this type of variation, it will come and you have to solve that. So this is the thing. Okay, so let us do one more exercise. Let us do this one. So if you have a MOSFET M2 like this, this is your VDD, this is M1, this is this thing here, and then you have Vin, and here you have Vout. So this is the configuration. What is this configuration actually? Can anybody tell me? Okay, so the thing is, this is the CMOS inverter, and the thing is, I want to calculate the voltage gain of this particular configuration. Then how to do it? The voltage gain of this particular configuration can be calculated like this. If you have a MOSFET M1, here your source is this. This is your Vin. This is your, you know, Vin this side. For this MOSFET M1, you have GM1, VGS, and then it has its own resistance RO1. What about the MOSFET M2? The MOSFET M2 is a PMOS version. So in this PMOS version, what happens is, as I told you earlier also, let us draw this PMOS separately. The circuit of PMOS and NMOS will remain same, as I told you earlier. So you can draw like this. It is GM2 RO2 here, and you have a VGS this side. So this is only for MOSFET M2. So here you can see, this is the source of the MOSFET, this is the drain of the MOSFET, and this is the gate of the MOSFET in case of M2 transistor. And from here you can see that the source of the MOSFET this side is grounded, and the drain of the MOSFET is connected to drain of M1 here. So what you can do is, you have to connect this point, which is the drain here, to the drain of the M1 here. So if you connect the drain of an M1 here to the drain of this, what you will get is this. This will be RO2, and the current will go up because you are connecting the drain and your source is this side. And source is this side, and source is grounded, so it is like this. So its value is GM2 VGS. This is the value for PMOS transistor. And what is VGS here? The VGS here will be, this is your source line, and your VGS will be this. This is your VGS. So this is the small signal equivalent for this circuit which we have over here, in which your M1 and M2 are connected in a CMOS inverter fashion, and what we have to do now, we have to calculate voltage gain, which is Vout divided by Vin. This is what we have to calculate. So now how will you do that? It's very easy here. You copy this, I'm putting it here. So what is this? This is RO2 which is connected to, this is RO2 which is connected to ground. So you can actually connect RO2 like this, because this is also ground. So here you can remove it from this side because it's already connected to ground. So you just copy it and keep it like this. And how about this current source? This current source is going up, and it is going to the ground actually. If you see, this current is going up to the ground. So what you can do is you can take this current source and bring it down, because it's anyway going to the ground. So you can take this current source and bring it down like this, and its value will be Gm to VGS. And now you can remove this also. So you can see this VGS is also gone, and this VN is, this VIN is this thing over here, which is the same as VGS. So your circuit is reduced to this fashion, and now you can further simplify it by seeing that these two resistances RO1 and RO2, they are parallel, and these two current sources are also in parallel, so they can we can add them together. So these two current sources and these two resistances which are in parallel can be combined together into one format, and that will be, you can remove this and you can make it RO1 parallel RO2, and you can remove one of the current source here and you can write it as GM1 VGS. You can write like this. So the both the current sources are added and both the resistances are this side. So what is the value of Vout over Vin? The value of Vout over Vin is minus GM1 plus GM2 times VGS, which is Vin, it's gone now, times RO1 parallel RO2. So this is the voltage gain for this particular configuration, which is given over here, this side. So this is the voltage gain for a CMOS inverter, which is acting as an amplifier. So this is the one. So today I finished off all the configurations of the common source amplifier. In the next class, we will go further and see what are the different configurations that we have in literature, and we will discuss them also in detail. So if you have any questions for today's class, let me know. Otherwise, we will finish this class off. If you have any questions, let me know.